Just a few hours to the consecration of the Bishop-elect of Namirembe Diocese, Canon Moses Banja, the organizing committee has confirmed that everything is set to conduct the service this Sunday. The consecration service will be led by the Archbishop of the Church of Uganda, Reverend Dr. Samuel Stephen Kazimbamgalu.
So it's a big function, and we expect so many people to turn up. We have organized parking for the VVIP, but even if you have a sticker for VVIP, you might be requested to drop at the entrance. You come on foot and the car is parked in the gazetted parking space that has been provided.
The service will start at 9 a.m. and Christians are being urged to abide by the rules and regulations put in place to have a colorful day.
Don't have carry baggages. Don't carry things that you'll even regret when you have. You know, on such a function, you can expect anything. Well, we are in the event that something happens or slips out of our control, don't regret.
The organizing committee has applauded all those who contributed to the ceremony. The committee has also denied allegations of mismanagement of the funds and further highlighted on how the money was spent.
Church of Uganda founded schools in Namirembe Diocese. They have also contributed generously to ensure that tomorrow's function is a success. So I'd like to invite people to come, and as the canon has said, we take charge as we are here of our security, ensure we do not come with the extra luggage.
So there are things we haven't done as per the budget, like completing the acquisition of the bishop's car, which is a process ongoing. So it is not as I've heard in the papers that we have already bought a 500 million car. We haven't, but the process is on.
The bishop-elect of Namirembe Diocese, Venerable Canon Moses Banja, will be the sixth bishop since the inception of Namirembe Diocese. Canon Moses Banja will replace the Right Reverend Wilberforce Chito Lualida, who was the Bishop of Namirembe Diocese for a period of 14 years. Lualida's tenure expired yesterday on 8th December 2023 after clocking the retirement age. Report compiled by Ismail Nsubuga for the news.